Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are participating in the Pink Fresh Friday hop, and this is a great time to dig into that Pink Fresh Studio stash and use it up a little bit. And I certainly have a huge collection of Pink Fresh, so let's get started. Right now I'm going to be using this circle punch and cutting out some of the circles from this piece of paper. And part of that is because I'm going to kind of make a diagonal design. I'm working with a topiary picture from Magic Kingdom. It's a sea monster that I noticed the last time we were at Magic Kingdom. I had never seen it before, and so I want to kind of take advantage of some of these plant kinds of pictures, and so I'm going to add those as well as a few phrases, and I'm also going to cut up a couple of these kind of journaling cards as well to add to my design. So now I have all my circles cut out, and I'm just kind of arranging to see what I have. And I'm gonna go ahead and back my photo as well as my journaling. I went ahead and typed up my journaling, and I wanted to go ahead and back that with some black cardstock, just to give it a little bit of a pop. The majority of this layout is gonna be very light and pastel, so I really wanted to put in just that little pop of black. So that's what I'm going to do here. And my journaling just basically talks about how there's always something to see when you go to Disney. And this is no exception. I had never seen this topiary. It's kind of by the entrance to Tomorrowland. And I don't know if it's new or if it's been there for, 50 years. But it was new to me. And so it was really cool to kind of see. They have a sea monster that's similar in Disney Springs in the water, so I'd never seen one made out of a topiary. So now I'm going to take some of my cut-aparts and just find... this is going to be a pretty monochromatic layout. I'm really going to stay with some blues and greens. It's not totally monochromatic, but really, really cool colors. And here's a fun trick that I found as well. The packaging in a lot of the ephemera packs has a really cool pattern on that, and it's kind of a cardstock weight, and it's great to use on your layouts. Of course, it comes with ephemera packs, so it is acid free if that's a concern for you, and it just adds a little extra into your stash if that's what you're looking for. And so I really like this. And you'll see here, despite even measuring it with my T-square, I did manage to still get my picture crooked. So I will be adjusting that later. Of course, I had already put several things on before I realized that it was crooked. But, you know, you just kind of go with it. And maybe this is a lesson to me that T-squares and I are just not friends. I think I do much better if I just eyeball it. So I'm just going to go down that diagonal and layer up my circles and just kind of get an idea of where I want them to be. I'm going to pop up a couple of them, and I am being mindful of colors. So I want to make sure that I have greens in both places and grays in both places and that sort of thing. So I am just going to be mindful about where I place those circles. And so once I am done with that, then I'm going to look at what other things I have here. And I do have these little journaling cards. I thought I was going to use that ticket. It did not end up working out, but I was able to use the ticket on the other side. And I really like this little phrase that said, just keep swimming, that I'm going to add as soon as I straighten my picture, which I finally figured out that, oh yeah, this is really crooked. So I'm going to add that just keep swimming up there and just kind of working on my embellishment clusters. So now I'm going to go to my ephemera packs, and I really love that about Pink Fresh, that a lot of their ephemera packs really work well with other ephemera packs. So you're not really limited to just one collection. You can really mix and match these collections pretty well. And that's something I really like to do. I am not one that stays with one particular collection and scrapbooks from there. I tend to pull from my stash and I tend to pull from different collections. And I'm glad that I do because I think it gives a really cool look to it. And yeah, so I do have to apologize. You are not going to see me finish up this layout because for some reason my camera has been being a real pain and has cut out on me. But I do hope that you'll be hopping along with us and checking out the others that are participating as well. And I hope you enjoy the close-ups. If you've not yet subscribed to my channel, I hope that you will consider subscribing so that you get a chance to see more layouts. And I love each and every one of my subscribers. So have a great day and I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.